Hello everyone. My name is Allison and I am very happy to have you here. Let's take the next step in our spiritual journey. Let's walk towards God together. Simply put, the law of attraction states that the things that we deeply and regularly think upon come into our experience, that is, they become a part of our reality. The law of attraction is very popular as people think that they can make their wishes come true simply by repeated contemplation on their wish. Remember one thing, the law of attraction does not distinguish between good thoughts and bad thoughts. It will simply attract that which you think. Hence, if we focus on something undesirable, the law of attraction will pull those vibrations closer to our experience and thereby, we might have to go through some unwanted situations. However, when it comes to God, nothing can be bad, right? The beautiful thing about contemplating on God is that even if we think of God in a negative way, it will still attract a spiritually positive outcome. Therefore, from a spiritual perspective, if we desire to elevate ourselves to a higher level of consciousness, we must repeatedly contemplate on this desire through sincere focus and exertion of willpower to the fullest. Let me illustrate this with a story. Shri Krishna had a cousin named Shishupal. Shishupal had a lot of hatred for Shri Krishna. He would leave no occasion to mock and insult Shri Krishna. One time, the eldest Pandava, Yudhisthira, organized a religious ceremony. Many kings in the neighboring kingdoms, including Shishupal and Shri Krishna, were invited for the ceremony. Since the Pandavas were devotees of Shri Krishna, they decided to make him a guest of honor. Seeing this, Shishupal started fuming. He sprang up and openly began to humiliate Shri Krishna. Now, we all know that God keeps account of our karmic actions. And at the right time, we have to face the consequences of our actions. However, it turns out, Shri Krishna had given a promise to Shishupal's mother that he would not kill him until Shishupal completes 100 sins. When Shishupal was reaching his 100 sins mark, Shri Krishna warned him of the same and asked him to stop. Shishupal, though, did not listen. He continued berating Shri Krishna. No sooner than Shishupal committed his 101st sin, Shri Krishna immediately threw his Sudarshan chakra at Shishupal, killing him instantly. But then, something magical happened. As Shishupal's corpse lay on the assembly, Shishupal's soul left the body and merged with Shri Krishna. That is, Shishupal attained liberation by merging with God. Watching this unfold, we might be taken by surprise. We all believe that, if one wants to attain liberation and merge with God, they must love God. Shishupal, on the other hand, despised Shri Krishna, yet he attained liberation. On being asked about this, Narad Muni told Yudhisthira that although Shishupal would constantly think only of Shri Krishna, albeit in a hateful manner. And as I mentioned before, the law of attraction does not differentiate between good thoughts and bad thoughts. It simply brings into our experience what we focus upon. Since Shishupal constantly thought of God, eventually, he attained God. Thus, as I had stated in the beginning of this video, even if we contemplate on God in a negative way, it will still attract a spiritually positive outcome. The lesson here is that one must always be conscious of one's thoughts. The law of attraction is always at work, and we can learn to use it for our benefit if we exert our willpower in an appropriate direction. That is all for now. If this video was valuable to you, please share it with your loved ones and subscribe to this channel for more updates. Thank you and take care.